Continues. Once again, here's your host, Booker.
Well, how did that feel, gentlemen?
I'm not going to lie, it felt pretty good.
Did it feel good?
It felt great.
I got to see the very first show at SoFi, sort of your first, I guess, moment back. And I feel, Dexter, when you walked out initially, there was that little bit of a pregnant pause. There was that, oh, I know how to do this.
Yeah, it was a little strange at first. It had been like a year and a half since we played anything, so it was really It was weird for a minute, but it was cool once we got started.
What goes through your mind? Remembering the songs, the chords.
Yeah, exactly. What do we say to these people now? You know.
Noodles didn't have a problem. Now he seemed a little.
I was nervous. I was nervous as hell. Like before we went out there, but then as soon as I walked out and saw the smiling faces, you knew that they were on our side. Then I went, oh yeah, I remember how to do this. I know I can do this. It was incredible.
Did you feel the need that you had to pick up Dexter a little bit? Did you see him with that apprehensive look? Because you did. You snapped right into it.
We were both kind of, I think he was less nervous before we got on stage. Once we got on stage, we were both, okay, normal nervousness. But we were so stoked. It was great to look over and see him smiling. And I think it's probably the same for him to see me smiling.
Weird seeing people for the first time, like having them in front of you again?
It was. It was cool. Felt natural.
Let's talk about this album. We're here to celebrate the album. There's so many, it's so quintessential, The Offspring. It really is. And you covered yourself. Congratulations on doing that. Gone Away, it feels like now. You really changed it up. Where did you get the idea to say, hey, let's rework this? Was it something you saw on the internet, or did you really pick up that song really works right now?
Yeah, Gone Away is an old song of ours from the Exhale the Hombre record, and it's a very like rock version, and we played it like that for a long time. But the lyrics are kind of heavy, and we wanted to do a different version that brought out that emotion, and so we started doing it really just live for fun on the piano, and it seemed to really work, and kind of, I felt like it was connecting, so we decided to record it and put it on the record all over again.
What's that like for you?
To re-record our stuff? Yeah. I don't think there's been any song that has touched people more deeply than that song has. So it was great to have a real dynamic moment on stage, and we thought let's do that with a record too. You know, we'd been doing that like probably 4 or 5 years. Mm-hmm. So it just really meant a lot, and I think people have reacted positively to it. And I think we did a fantastic job on that one.
I love it. It really is. It feels fresh all over again. Want to play some music? I feel like the people want to see you play some music. Let's do it. It is live with The Offspring. Let's play it right now. The Offspring. Go ahead, guys.
Crazy, crazy.
Living, the title track from their 10th,
wow,
10th studio album. That's crazy, man. That was awesome. Let's talk about that. Let's talk about that song. The title, right in the midst of the pandemic, is that when you came up with this?
Yeah, it just seemed like the right slogan for the moment, right?
Were you in the thick of it then? Were we at the end of the pandemic? Was everything just starting to unravel? How much music was recorded at this time? Take me back.
I mean, a lot of the album came together in the last couple of years, and you know, there was a lot of stuff going on before the pandemic, of course, but somehow this kind of seemed to just wrap it all up nicely, and you know, things are crazy, obviously. That title just seemed like the right title to go with.
Is it an optimistic time, or are we still pessimistic?
Well, you got to address the tough times, but you also have to have some kind of hope at the end of it. You know, we're hopeful people, and I think, you know, in terms of the pandemic, we see ourselves coming through the end of this. Thank you for all wearing masks, by the way. We appreciate that.
That's right.
You know, the end of the end times is near, I think. We'll get back to the before times soon enough. So, yeah, we're very optimistic.
Okay. 9 years in between, I know you weren't just watching Netflix or whatever. You guys, you toured. You did a song for Sharknado. Yep. Dexter got his PhD in molecular biology. I had to look that up. To that, I'll say, huh?
Why did I get a PhD?
Yeah, I mean, were you just thinking, thumbing through the what I could do during some downtime? I know. I'll get a degree in molecular, what is this, why?
I wanted a backup plan in case the band didn't work out.
Josh is fitting in nicely, by the way. Okay. What's harder, writing a song or a dissertation?
Well, when it comes to Sharknado, I mean, we're such big fans, and so that one came naturally, came easily.
Yeah, Sharknado. We love Sharknado. Come on. Who does not love Sharknado? I don't know a lot of people that love molecular biology, but everybody loves Sharknado.
That's right.
I don't know what it is.
We waited patiently until Sharknado 6. They didn't ask us for the first one or the second one or the third one, but I think it was 6, right?
You got the good one. You really got the good one. Congratulations on that. 8 years. I mean, how much of this music did you record after the pandemic? How much was sitting in a drawer already, Noodles?
Yeah, a lot of this actually came together in the last couple of years, right before we put it out. We were ready to put the record out and the pandemic hit, and then we just kept working on it because we didn't want to put out a record when we couldn't tour on it. A couple of things are older. We Never Have Sex Anymore has been around for a while, kicking around on that. But a lot of this came together, like, This Is Not Utopia. We're not playing it tonight, unfortunately, but This Is Not Utopia came out, just like, it's one of the last songs written for the record. Mm-hmm.
Is it hard to get back into the gear sitting at home for so long, not doing what you do?
Yeah, it kind of is. It takes a minute to get back into it. The first few times we went to the studio, it wasn't happening. And then all of a sudden you get in the flow.
Are the new songs hard to play?
Not anymore. We, you know,
how much you rehearse? You've been rehearsing a lot.
Yeah, because what else are we going to do? We're stuck at home. We can't go out and tour. We want to do it together and play. So we worked really hard on getting the whole new record. We've never been more prepared to play a new record than we are right now. But it's been a blast just getting in the studio and just playing, you know, just as a band. It's been a blast.
It's been a long journey. I remember the first time I was in my friend's Jetta, and I heard this little drum beat that's about to play. It's been a long road. Congratulations on it. Let's play some music. The Offspring, everybody.
You gotta keep them separated. Like a spreading disease, separated.
Hey, man, you're disrespecting me.
Check him out.
Gotta keep them separated.
Hey, don't pay no mind. You're under 18, you won't be doing any time. Hey, come out and play.
Separated.
Hey, man, you're talking back to me.
Take him out.
Gotta keep them separated.
Hey, don't pay no mind. You're under 18, you won't be doing any time. Hey, come on and play.
Separated.
Hey, man, you're disrespecting me.
Take him out.
Gotta keep them separated.
Hey, don't pay no mind. You're under 18, you won't be doing any time. Hey, come out and play.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. We're gonna play another song off the new record. This song's called "We Never Have Sex Anymore," and what's gonna? it's about not having sex. You know, when people, we're recording the song, and people are saying, "Why are you writing a song about not having sex?" People want to hear songs about having sex. Like, "Get Lucky" is the most famous song in the world, right? And I said, "Well, this is a song for the rest of us. This is, you know, about like noodles."
Well, I think anyone who's been in a relationship longer than a couple of weeks knows what it's like when that passion starts to wane, right? So
yes.
That's what this song is about. Everybody's, you know, that's love is a roller coaster, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know if that's...
Not that it's about us. It's not about us necessarily. It's not autobiographical.
Totally about people we know, though.
Right. We've seen it.
Yes.
Right. All right. Let's do it.
Sex anymore. We never roll around on the floor like we did so long ago. And you never yell at me anymore. You never want to even the score like you did so long ago. But you're still with me, so I guess I'm not complaining. And you are. Strive. You never even threatened my life like you did so long ago.
constantly. We used to have a ball. We used to do it everywhere. Now we never do it at all.
It is iHeartRadio live with The Offspring celebrating their latest album. It's got a swing to it, and yet it's a song about not swinging. I see what you did there. I'm on to you guys. I'm on to you guys. And you made a video with monkeys, too. That was probably a career goal.
Well, we thought that John Stamos and Todd were pretty handsome, so we decided to put them in the video, you know.
You worked with Bob Rock again. Was it important this time around when, you know, when the world was so uncomfortable for so long to have someone that really has been in your corner before? Was that important for you?
We've worked with Bob for, I don't know, 15 years now. So it's just kind of, we know each other so well, and he's, you know, part of the family, and he's a friend, and it just really made sense to work with him again.
I read you did this partly at home. Did you just now build a studio after all of these years, or is the...
No, we've actually had a studio for a number of years. Even we started out just a place where Dexter would kind of demo. He'd kind of woodshed and demo, and then we started recording in there, rehearsing in there. We've had it for a number of years, actually.
Cool. You guys did the You guys have seen Carpool Karaoke, right? We've seen that before, but the band just
boring!
Scoffs at that boring show with your own version, Cockpit Karaoke. Dexter, a pilot, a physician. What's next, Dexter? Open heart surgery? Where did you come up with this Cockpit Karaoke? Did you see this and say we should just try it?
Well, I'm not a real doctor. I just have a PhD, just that kind of doctor, right? No, we try to get on Carpool Karaoke, but they didn't want us. So we thought,
I don't think the people at home can hear the booing. Hold on.
They didn't. We made our little thing, submitted it. Anyway.
I had to get that in. It was too easy. We've got about another 30 minutes or so with The Offspring on our video stream. Join us on youtube.com/iHeartRadio for even more. I want to thank you guys for being here tonight. Let the bad times roll by Offspring. This has been a lot of fun, and it's great to see you guys again. And it's even better. We can't see their faces, but we can see their eyeballs, and they seem to be pretty happy. So thank you all for coming. Thank you all for watching. Thank you, everybody at home, for listening. For iHeartRadio Live, my name is Booker. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, of course, The Offspring.
Still in time, hard to see. Fragile.
guys. I'm Booker as we continue with The Offspring and our iHeartRadio album release party on our YouTube channel. This is where we turn it over to the fans hanging out virtually with us on Zoom tonight. Let's go with, first of all, you guys good? Is that, I jumped on him very quickly. Diana's got a question. Diana, you with us? There she is.
What is your guys' favorite song to perform live?
All of them, really. I know that sounds contrite, you know, but really, or not contrite, trite, sounds trite.
I mean, that one for sure is one of our favorites, The Kids on Our Right, right? Yeah. That one seems to really always go over super great with everybody, so it's one of the more fun ones, probably.
Yeah. All the new stuff has been fun to play for the first time. By the way, we never have sex anymore. We've never played that for an audience before. That was our first time tonight.
That's right. That was our first time.
So thank you for being here for that. Thank you for checking us out at home for that. That was fun.
What's the most challenging song for you guys to play? Is there one? Is there one that I could screw this one up?
Oh, man, all of them. Have you heard me play guitar? No. Kids Aren't All Right. That intro is like, it's rough. It's fast.
You nail it, though, dude. You rip.
Yeah. Totally no, I nailed it just then. Yeah. I don't know if you heard. Yeah.
That's right.
You guys seem like buddies forever. And are there the bad times between you two ever? I mean, you guys really have one another's back always.
We don't talk to each other on the tour bus, but on stage. Separate. No. We're buddies for sure. We hang out and drink beer and talk trash. It's fun.
And write music.
I love you, man.
Not as much as I love you, man.
There's my moment.
Yeah. Am I blushing? He's blushing. Am I blushing? Yeah, we're blushing right now.
He's a little red. Robin has a question for The Offspring. Let's do this.
What is the weirdest thing a fan has ever done for y'all?
Probably the guy who lit himself on fire and did a stage dive.
That's right. That was.
We don't recommend you do that. I mean, we love our fans, and we love when they express their enthusiasm for what we do, but don't light yourselves on fire for us.
That's right. Lighting off fire. Yeah. Jumping off of balconies has happened a couple times.
Like in theaters, yeah, the balcony. Yeah, don't do that.
All right, one more fan question. Jonathan, we see you on our virtual fan wall here. Let me just ask the question. The band has continued to transform and keep up with the times and changing sounds over the course of decades while still retaining the same feel. What is the band's key to success with regards to this longevity? It's a tough one.
I mean, we really love it. I mean, it's really as easy as that. It's something that we enjoy doing, and we're still inspired to try to make the best music that we can.
That is exactly right. You gotta love the music that you're making, you know, and otherwise people will, I think, see through that. So.
Have you ever made songs that have gotten away from the Offspring sound and you trash it and say, that's not us?
For sure. I think when you're writing songs, it's kind of like it sounds funny to say, but you almost let the song go where it wants to go and then kind of sort it out later whether it works for you or not.
Dexter likes to call the studio where the heartbreak happens, because he'll have an idea in his head. We get in the studio and we start putting it down and we go, oh man, this just isn't working. You know?
Does he ever ruin your riff? You're like, no, I wanted to do this though.
All the time. Yeah.
Good to know. Let's play some more music. The Offspring. It is the iHeartRadio live with The Offspring.
Thank you. you could only read my mind, you would know that things between us ain't right. I know your arms are open wide, but you're a little off the straight side. I can't lie. Your word lies, cause you're too nice. Come around now, can you see?
There's some gnarly mosh pits going on in here, you know?
We should do this every Thursday night!
We should. We totally should.
Why didn't we do this the whole pandemic? Come on!
When they say live, it's not like really live, right? It's like sort of live. They're gonna fix it up and play it later or something.
These people look live to me! Looks like an audience to me!
All right. Well, maybe this live in studio audience would like to sing this next part with us. What do
yes!
you think?
Yes!
All right, here we go. Drivers on read, such attitudes, but when I show my peace, complete seat, something's odd. Feel like I'm gone, you stupid, dumb shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it ain't going away. pretty fly.
Montag, lieben, lauten, loben.
Give it to me, baby.
Girly say I'm pretty fly for a white guy.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, cinco, seis.
You know it's kinda hard just to get along today. Our subject isn't cool, but he fakes it anyway. He may not have a clue and he may not have style, but everything he lacks probably makes up in denial.
I don't know, like, how more rad could it be? Like, none more rad. This is hella rad.
It feels really good to play some shows again.
I just gotta say, everyone listening out there on the interwebs, this is the sexiest internet audience that we've ever played to in our lives. So, thank you all for tuning in.
Have we played to a lot of internet audiences?
We have not. So, but don't let that hold you back, internet audience. You're sexy. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise.
Right.
Thank you guys all for being here tonight, and thank you all for tuning in. It means the world to us. It really does.
Show me how to lie. You're getting better all the time and turn it all against one. Is it art that's hard to teach? Another clever word sets off an unsuspecting hurt. And as you step back in the line, a mob jumps to their feet. Now dance, fucker, dance, man. You never had a chance. And no one even knew it was really only you. And now you steal away. Take your mouth today. Nice work.
Between the eyes, hit 'em right between the eyes. We walk away, nothing more to
you want? Well, it's all because of me. Now dance, fucker, dance, man. I never had a chance, and no one even knew it was really only you. And now you lead the way. Show the light of day. Nice work you did. You gotta go fuck it with a thousand lies and a good disguise. Hit a right between the eyes. Hit a right between the eyes. When you walk away, nothing more to say. See the lightning in your eyes. See you running for the light. Now dance, fucker, dance. He never had a chance, and no one even knew it was really only you. So dance, fucker, dance. I never had a chance. It was really only you. With a thousand lies and a good disguise. Hit her right between the eyes. Hit her right between the eyes. When you walk away, nothing more to say. See the lightning in your eyes. See you running.
There you go. It is iHeartRadio Live with The Offspring. You guys are awesome, man. You guys are really awesome. It's awesome to share a stage with you, just doing this with actual fans in front of us. Thank you all for watching on YouTube. Thank you all for being in the audience. Thank you for being vaxxed and maxed up. We appreciate that. Everybody, have a great night. The Offspring, everybody. Don't forget to get the album. Let the Bad Times Roll out now. From the iHeart Theater in Los Angeles, I'm Booker. Everybody, good night. Thanks for watching, listening. We appreciate it. The Offspring.